Hello everyone. Today let us see how to prepare homemade Domino's style or Pizza Hut pizza in a simple and easiest way with simple ingredients. Earlier, if you have watched our videos, we have prepared mug pizza and also bread pizza. But the original pizza is this. It takes some time, but trust me, worth the wait. So everybody will love this. You can watch the videos in the description, links will be given, and also try this pizza. You'll truly love it, and you'll have the best time with your family or friends with this homemade pizza. Just watch this video till the end and just follow all the tips and tricks I tell you, and you can have the same taste and yummy pizza. So let us start. First, take a bowl and add 2 tablespoons of dry active yeast. You need to take 2 tablespoons because later we're going to take 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour or maida. So both the quantities should be same. Now add lukewarm water or water at room temperature. Remember, water should not be too hot or too cold. If it is, then your yeast will die. So remember, it should be lukewarm water. Stir it nicely and then add 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now the yeast feeds on the sugar and it starts to double. So allow it to rest for 10 to 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, your yeast will be fluffier. It will be almost double or triple. See, this is so fluffy. Now this is the consistency. You will get silky consistency. Stir it nicely and then add 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour or maida. Once your yeast is fluffier, remember, you will get an awesome pizza. If it is not, try for the second time. Now add a pinch of salt and add little bit of water, little by little if required, and then knead it nicely. You know, you doesn't need to knead the dough like chapati dough or puri dough, but remember, it should be a little bit stickier like this only. So knead it nicely and then add a little bit of oil and again knead it properly till the oil is spread for the entire dough, like this. So once you are done kneading it, it turns soft. Now again, make it into a circular dough and allow it to set. Now you can use a damp cloth or else you can cover the lid so that no air is passed. Here I have taken a kitchen wrap and I have folded, sealed it nicely, and then I have put a time lapse so that I can show you how this dough has doubled and tripled. So see, I have allowed it to set for 2 hours. Minimum 2 hours is required if you're planning for a pizza. You need the dough to rest for 2 hours. See, little by little it's increasing. See, it's tripled almost. So if your dough comes like this, then remember, you will get the perfect dough. Now after perfect pizza, I'm sorry. So after 2 hours, remove the wrap or the cloth and then see, nicely, it is like the earlier one when we prepared the stickier dough. So now gradually add little by little of dough and then prepare it into a smooth soft ball of maida dough or all purpose dough. I think I have added another 1/2 cup of all purpose flour or maida. Now with the help of your hands, nicely you need to knead it. See, with the help of my palm, I'm kneading it nicely. So you to do the same thing, you have to press it gently, but you need to do it thoroughly. Now take this chapati rolling board and add all purpose flour on top of it and place the dough on top of it, and gently you need to press it again. See, you need to stretch like this with the same manner with using your palm. And you need to use both your hands and then you need to fold it inside and again you need to stretch it nicely. You need to do this for at least 5 minutes for a softer pizza. And then roll it inside so that your dough doesn't have any cracks. For crackless dough, you need to fold it inside and make it into a small dough. So our dough is ready. So later you need to place it again on the rolling board and then press it gently with your hand and add a little bit of all-purpose flour on top of it, and with both the hands you need to press it like this and then again dab it gently on top of it to spread the dough evenly on all sides. So like this, in middle, if you want, you can add this all-purpose flour again and roll it with the help of a rolling pin. Main thing you need to remember is, do not put pressure on the rolling pin or the dough. You need to do it on a very gentle manner or just like a feather touch manner. See, I'm doing the same way. If you press it hard, your pizza base will become like a chapati or else like papad. So just remember that your dough need to be, your dough should be fluffy and soft. So see what I have done is, in the middle I have put and rolled to the outer side so that it spreads gently. See, like this. So I'm spreading like this. You have to do the same. Do not put pressure on the rolling pin much. So after that, you take a plate. See, I have taken the base of the pizza. So on which you are cooking, you take that, and in that shape only you cut the pizza. So with that size, I have taken a similar size of that plate, and then I am cutting the edges of the pizza base. I have taken the pizza cutter over here. If you don't have a pizza cutter, you can take a knife also. So remove the plate on top of it. So finally our pizza base is ready. I have done this on the oven glass itself. If you don't have, you can also do it on the other baking trays also. So flip the pizza base from the chapati roll board to the base glass again, and then gently fold into the towards the inner side. After folding it, the top which the dough has, you have to press it gently in inner side, but do not press it hard or else it will become thick and that will be crunchier. So again, take a fork and then poke it nicely. This helps in baking from the bottom as well. This helps to circulate the air as well. So don't forget to poke your pizza base. This is important. Now take a pizza sauce and then spread it nicely. If you don't have a pizza sauce, you can also take a tomato ketchup and then add, you can spread it. Now here I have taken mozzarella cheese, shredded mozzarella cheese. If you don't have this, you can also take a cube and then you can grate it nicely. And then here I have taken bell peppers, yellow, red and green, and also onions, and I have diced it nicely into cube shape, and then again I have loaded with lots of cheese on top of it. You can add any vegetable of your choice. See, after loading it nicely, it's so yummy, and it looks so attractive. So after loading it with loads and loads of cheese, and now it's time to place it in our oven. Now I have preheated this oven at 170 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes, and then now I'm placing it to 200 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. I have set the time for 20 minutes, but it almost took 12 minutes to complete my pizza. So after 10 minutes, when I have checked, my pizza is like this. So I have allowed it to cook for almost 2 minutes more, and then ta-da, my pizza is all ready. See, this is so yummy and tasty. See how cheesy it is. Isn't so tempting? You also want to cook it, right? You also want to prepare the same pizza. Now go hurry and prepare this and enjoy with your family. Trust me, you will truly, truly relish having this pizza at home. This is so yummy and delicious. Now those who don't have oven, do not worry. You can proceed with the same process, but place this in a pan by placing a stand or else salt, and then close the lid and allow it to cook for 15 to 20 minutes. That's it. You can enjoy with oven or without oven. The pizza at home itself tastes better than Domino's and Pizza Hut. So enjoy and let me know how it turned to you in the comment section. Bye bye.